Here are seven people in Taiwan's arts and culture scene you should know about. You can find the full episodes and features in the description below. And if you think there's anyone else we should be following, let us know in the comments.
I feel like not a lot of people can do this kind of drag that I do. Because I feel like drag is a very Western concept. And a lot of people who grow up watching Drag Race have this idea of how to do drag through watching Drag Race. So they don't necessarily think of, oh, I could, you know, incorporate this, a more traditional way of doing drag, into their own drag because they aspire to maybe more Western drag.
Director Ing Zhenghao's success came years after his first award recognition. It was his persistent work that eventually propelled him to the next level. In 2019, this trilogy of music videos opened a door for Ing to fulfill a dream that he had given up on, to become a filmmaker. The videos caught the eye of an influential executive producer.
He didn't know why, he just wanted to get the idea to start opening YouTube to watch some MV. He suddenly jumped to the Wave of Love. He watched it very seriously. 看完那个MV之后, 他马上重播, 叫那个陈伟豪导演一起认真的看一下这个MV。 他们反复看了几次吧, 他们就觉得, 诶, 这个MV, 他们看见了叙事的可能, 角色的迷人, 还有一种独特的, 大家不是说那个台湾的美学嘛, 对, 有一个风格在里面, 他们才来询问了。
Ing joined the team and later got the opportunity to direct his first feature film, Man in Love. It was a huge success in Taiwan and hit 52.9 million USD box office worldwide. This, coupled with major award recognitions, Ing soon raised his profile and became an influential figure in the film industry.
这样的过程其实我觉得是大家都有彼此在聆听，你要在听你的member 现在要干嘛，有谁突然要 solo 了，或者是他又要一个过门了，那个过程这么专心的在聆听彼此的这个过程，我觉得现在台湾音乐可能比较少，对，因为现在大部分可能是固定做好的，然后可能focus 会在，比方说歌手唱的好不好啊，漂不漂亮。<笑> 有没有唱得很厉害啊，对，但是在 Let's My Show 有一个东西很酷，是我觉得就算我是歌手，但是其实我跟所有的人都有平均表现的机会，每一个人都是 artist。
I do feel like my career, all my work has been about, you know, exploring people and the situation on the margins and then present the complexity of it, you know, that to show how you know, what the gray area feels like, to show how, you know, the world is not that simple, that we all sort of struggle, and maybe the struggle is a positive thing because then we're less likely to have these knee-jerk reactions about good and evil and about, you know, one side versus the other. So, I mean, I think ultimately I would love, you know, people to continue to feel resonant, that this film resonate with their own personal story somehow. You know, I mean, on the identity side, on the sense of belonging side, which you don't have to be Taiwanese, you know, you don't have to know the situation here to understand that. I think we all, you know, have this struggle no matter where you are.
Ivy Chen has been teaching people how to cook traditional Taiwanese food for over 25 years. And in her pursuit of culinary perfection, she's also become an encyclopedia of Taiwanese food culture.
So this soy sauce made in Taiwan, basically with soybean and wheat, and that's a Japanese technique. Okay. So when Japanese colonized Taiwan 100 years ago, they left this technique to Taiwan.
You know, being able to do narrative is always kind of the dream or the goal per se. And so when I started out doing music video, I was doing a lot of narrative music videos. So most of the music videos that I've done are, a lot of it is storytelling. And And I think storytelling in music video is kind of like, silent films in a way. So it's a really good practice because film is, you know, a lot of it is about show not tell. And so when you are telling the story without, you know, relying on the dialogue, it's actually a really good practice.
话在我的生长经验里面，我们的教育里面，就是在学校我学的是芭蕾舞蹈、现代舞蹈、中国舞蹈，然后还有很多的所谓的舞蹈音乐课程。但是舞蹈音乐课程其实并没有包括，就是你去就是很多音乐类型，它其实不会在学校介绍，然后。很后来才认识了跳街舞的朋友，然后在这样子的音乐跟舞蹈的刺激里面，我觉得它是一个非常纯粹人类听到音乐会想要产生动作的一个过程，所以我一直都非常喜欢流行舞蹈。
Thanks for watching to the end. We hope you liked our list of 7 people you should know in Taiwan's arts and culture scene. Who was your favorite? Let us know in the comments.